Today I'm going to take you through the process of creating a custom painted camo job on this Remington 870 using the Brownells Alumahide 2 epoxy paint system. And the first thing you're going to notice is I'm going to paint this gun all together in one piece, as opposed to taking it apart and shooting the pieces individually. If I were to do that, I run the risk of getting paint in places I don't want it, and that can become a huge headache. One place I definitely don't want any paint is in the magazine tube and on the follower. So I'm going to use this piece of paper towel and tuck it down into the action and then close the bolt to keep it in place. Now I'm going to remove the butt plate, but I'm going to reinstall one of the mounting screws because this will make an excellent place to hang the shotgun. Well, now I'm going to degrease the shotgun, and I wanted to wait until I had it hanging to do this part of the process to eliminate the chance of recontaminating any of the surfaces by handling the gun. So once I've got it degreased, I won't touch it again. Now you notice I've set up a cardboard temporary paint booth here to protect the rest of my shop when I start spraying the paint. Take your time with this part of the process because this is what's really going to give the Alumahide the best chance of adhering to all of these surfaces. Now it's time to start laying down some color. And remember, Alumahide is an epoxy product, so you've got about a 30-minute work time with it, and that means you want to keep the process moving. Now I'm working with my lightest color first. This is Desert Tan. I want to go ahead and lay a nice even coat over the whole shotgun. I'm working into my darker colors now, and I've got the OD green. And there's really no right or wrong way to do this. Just lay it on light, keep the can moving, a little on the stock, maybe a little on the fore end here. Now I've got a little earth brown, just come right across the receiver. Now I've got a section of produce netting here, and I've got the darkest color we're going to use in the design, matte black. And I'm holding the netting against the shotgun. I want to get the can about 24 inches away. Just lightly misting. We're adding some definition and kind of tying all the colors together. There's no right or wrong way to do this. You just kind of a little here and a little there. Now, if you live in a warm climate and you can keep your shotgun between 90 and 100 degrees, the cure time for the Alumahide is going to be about 48 hours. Otherwise, at room temperature, around 70 degrees, you're looking at about a week. Either way, once it's cured, you take it down, reinstall your butt plate, remove that piece of paper towel, and you're good to go. And the Alumahide is going to give you a durable, long-lasting finish.